you guys are probably asking, why in the world are you standing here in front of an 8-foot cornfield? You just stay with us and you'll see.
Like that?
Is it gonna stand up?
Yep. Sure is.
Hey, all you guys out there watching this stuff, we just want to tell you how we practice. You see that deer down there? Probably can't hardly even see it. We've hunted in 100, 200 acre cornfields. We're on the edge of a cornfield here right now. And this is the kind of stuff that we recommend that you do, because if the corn is still standing in December, this is where the deer are going to be, in this corn. So you can come in here and just sit and wait and wait. If you're on a, if you know you're on a trail that's going through this corn, most likely you get a shot at a deer like this. So this is why we recommend that you do it like this. What we're talking about right there, man.
Good.
Down on my knees, you see the wind blowing this corn, blowing the scent that way. The deer are most likely going to be coming from that way, because they're going to be walking into the wind. It just so happens that we got our target set up there facing into the wind. But you have to figure all that stuff out. And the more you do this, the better you're going to be at it. But don't be intimidated by a cornfield. Standing corn is amazing. We have a video where we had a tripod set up in the end of a cornfield. We got some of the best footage we've ever had, the best buck fights we've ever seen. So go out to yourself to give it a try. This is the stuff that we do all the time. I know you guys out there, a lot of people that I talk to are very intimidated, you know, doing anything but getting in a tree stand, hunting a run right in front of your stand. But, you know, me and Guy and Kevin all highly recommend that you guys step outside the box and try some different stuff. You'll be successful if you try it enough. And yes, we got girls on our pro staff. Kevin's daughter, Jess, his granddaughters. We're a family, man. We all hunt for the meat. Yeah, we get some nice bucks once in a while, but that's okay if we get a small buck. Nowadays, we're using a lot different equipment. This Verdix, I'm telling you right now, leaves like this, that's no challenge for these modern day bows. You can shoot through these leaves like they're not even there. So don't be intimidated by that, but practice enough that you know that you know that you know you're gonna be able to make that happen. So that's the best tip of the day right there.